I just found something incredible at this Goodwill behind me, which I'll show you guys here in a bit. But also, someone had their wedding at our store. We'll tell you guys that story too later today. This was a crazy, crazy week. Got to the store and we pulled some orders. We sold a lot of the PlayStation 2 games that we just got in, which is super cool. We have a little GameCube order here, little PSP game. We have a mystery box right here that I filmed a short for that's going to be going up on the Double Jump Extras channel. More PlayStation, we have some Switch games, we have more GameCube here, Mega Yarn Yoshi and the Parappa plush. We have some PSP and Famicom, and then we have another little random bundle here. You ready for today? You ready for today? You ready for today? Are you ready for today? Bobby.
What's up?
Are you scared?
I'm very scared.
It's getting close to Halloween.
Yeah. Showed them that yet?
Not yet.
It's got a little like...
They can't see it yet. They can't see it.
Oh.
No, not yet.
Not yet? Oh, okay.
It's pretty scary though.
It's pretty scary, yeah.
You remember Ariel, when I did the intro and I said that I found something cool at Goodwill? Do you remember that?
I wasn't here for that, but yes.
Well, I did it at Goodwill. Do you remember it though?
Yeah, now I do, yeah.
Okay, well, this is what I found! It's so cool!
But what's her name?
Tabitha.
Tabitha Beatrice.
Isn't it so freaking cool? Guess what the best part was, Bobby.
Was it half off coupon?
It was half off! And the original price was only $20, so it was $10. And I got 5% off because I have the new Goodwill card thing.
She's got like a motor in her. Yeah, there's like a battery in here.
I felt like it had to be remote control.
All right, turn it on. I didn't try. Yeah, what does it do? The legs just close around Ariel.
I don't even know if she still has batteries in her though.
Shoots out a spider web.
Okay, no, there's 9-volt batteries in here.
9-volt battery? Would this be helpful?
Is she like...
Yeah, what would it even do?
Who knows?
Is she like motion activated?
Because you were able to just move the legs.
So yeah, the legs have like wires in them and stuff.
Yeah, that's weird. Maybe the eyes light up in the dark or something? I don't know.
I imagine she makes sound.
Can you turn it on?
Yeah, I'm flipping the switch. The battery's supposed to be dead.
Hmm. Well, either way, $10 for this thing was crazy.
We gotta get some 9-volts.
I imagine if we're not gonna sell this, this is gonna be store decoration for the holidays. But I imagine if I did put a price tag on it at $100, somebody would buy it day one. It's just so cool. Look how freaking big this thing is. I had to fold all the legs under like it was dead to fit it in the backseat of my car.
But you're not dead, are you?
But we have the perfect spot for her. So, now that we have gotten all these PlayStation 2 games entered from this massive collection, if you did not see the last video we put out, definitely check it out because this is like over 600 PS2 games that we got, which is insane. But now that we've gone through them all, we have gotten them all into the inventory, they're priced, they're stickered, they have been filmed and photographed. Now we have the fun time of cleaning all the cases, which I was doing as I was sorting them as well. I was getting a lot of stickers off. They're not perfect, but I did what I could. And then we need to sort them for resurfacing. This is going to take forever because all of these need to be sorted for resurfacing as well. So this is like 700-ish games and our machine can only do 50 at a time. And just to do a stack of 50 games, depending on the level you put it on, of course, that can take a few hours. So even though this machine is super awesome and does a great job, this is going to be a multi-day process. We've been watching the Mario movie a little bit over the past few days, and I wanted to show you guys where we put the spider, Tabitha. Right there. She's kind of like crawling out from behind Yoda. Very creepy. We figured out that the eyes were supposed to light up, but we put brand new batteries in it. Looks like it wasn't really doing anything. So we got her kind of crawling out from around Yoda. It looks all creepy and I love it. So cool. We're definitely going to be keeping this, and we'll use it every year for like Halloween decoration around the store. But at the new store for next Halloween, there's going to be way more room to find a good spot for her. We just got some broken controllers photographed to go on eBay. PS4, PS5 in here. We got PS3 in this one, and this one is all PS2. We have a ton. And we have more coming, so if you're one of the people that likes to get the broken stuff and repair it and then sell it.
It's more like 75 pounds than a ton.
It's like 4 tons. Check out our eBay link down below. These are going to be going up before this video goes live. So if you want, you can check it out. We have more stuff coming, but this is all that we had time to get photos of for today.
Yeah.
That's it for today, guys. We will see you in a second.
Bye.
Have you been in a video before?
Cooper, what is today? What's today? What's today? What's today?
My birthday!
Happy birthday.
And I gave Cooper this t-shirt.
Cable Corpse. And a bunch of other t-shirts.
And I made him dinner last night, and I made him breakfast this morning, and I made him a cake, and I forgot it at home.
Nice.
And then,
to
Cooper, well, yo Cooper from Babe.
Happy birthday.
Even though I told him not to get me anything.
Oh, that's what you said. Oh, Nintendo plush.
This is the plush that came in, and I was like, I'm thinking about keeping this, but I didn't.
And then, so Colton, what was your idea?
Oh, so I was like,
thank you, Bobby.
I should get something for Cooper from the store, because that'd be funny. And then I was like, no, I'll get him a sick Cooper t-shirt and a pin. Because that'd be really funny. And then I was like, no, I should have someone make a sick Colton shirt and pin. And then but I only thought of that yesterday, so I didn't nearly have enough time to put something together.
No, it's perfect.
The thought is enough.
The thought is enough.
That's what counts anyway.
Yoshi.
This is a Japanese exclusive Club Nintendo Yoshi plush. And we got it from our
stop looking
stuff
at his
from
butt.
Japan. I'm showing the tag.
It's a secret. Secret way to stare up his butt.
And the bottom of the apple is like, what do you call that material?
I don't know, but you're showing his butt again.
Leather, plastic.
Yeah, it's
vinyl.
Like, yeah, it's different from the rest of the plush, and it's very cool.
Happy birthday!
Thank you, Bobby! So we are still continuing to print the artwork for the Zelda things. We have, I think, a little over 200 done so far. We need about 350, so we're still working on that. And the boxes are the last thing that we're waiting on to arrive in the mail. And right now they are stuck at customs. And we submitted all the information that they needed on Sunday. And right now it's Thursday. It's supposed to only take 1 to 3 business days. Today's the 4th business day, which is not good. Hopefully there's no problems. There's no sort of like Nintendo logos or branding on the boxes at all, so it's nothing like that. Not exactly sure what's holding it up, but I was hoping we'd have about a week or so to put the boxes together and get everything ready, so once we get the games in the mail, we just pop them in real quick, box them up, and get them shipped out. But it's looking like we're going to probably have to put the boxes together just in like a day or two, which we're talking 350 boxes. It's not going to be like a 10-minute process. You know, it's going to take quite a few hours, most likely. Because we can't just rush through and mess them up. We got to make sure we're careful with them. So, anyway, we'll let you guys know as soon as those do come in the mail. Show them to you. Show you what the finished product of everything's going to look like all together. And I'm super excited. Thank you guys for your support. And I do apologize to anyone that wanted to get one. But we only had 350 boxes pre-ordered. So that's the amount of... that's the amount of orders we could take for the game. We will have extra copies of the normal game. They just won't include the pre-order bonuses. So pre-orders for the new Zelda with our pre-order bonuses are sold out. But once the game comes out, if you do want to just buy a normal copy from us, you'll still be able to. So, Abby.
So, Cooper.
This is the moment that everyone's been waiting for. So this happened when I was not here.
Mm-hmm.
This was Saturday or Sunday? I can't remember.
I don't remember.
Either way, I wasn't here, but Abby's gonna tell you guys the story of
it
what happened
Saturday.
Over this last weekend, because it's crazy.
It is crazy. And I feel like every time I say that, like, I'm like, oh, we can't top this, and then something else happens, and I think that this is like top tier craziness. Two regular customers of ours who have been shopping with us since we opened back in 2018 asked us if they could get married at our store because it meant so much to them, and they wanted to have us as witnesses.
Well, also because they said that, like, they didn't really have any family that lives around here or anything.
And so they needed witnesses. So, right. They shot me a Facebook message, and I was like, oh my God, yes. And I never check my Facebook messages. I happened to just open up Messenger, and I saw the message, and it had come in, like, 3 minutes prior. And I was just like, absolutely, all in caps. And then I took a screenshot, and I sent it to Cooper, and Cooper was like, what? What is happening? Who is that? And I was like, this is a regular of ours. So we witnessed Alex and Jeff getting married at the store. And they are a wonderful couple that, like I said, has been shopping with us since the very, very beginning. They are so sweet. They come in weekly, sometimes twice a week. And it is always an absolute blast having conversations with them, talking to them. Alex loves Animal Crossing, so she's collecting all of the Animal Crossing cards. We just sold them a pack of Sanrio cards. And we did happen to get a small clip of their ceremony. After I got the message that morning, I went over to Jorge's Bakery, and I...
Which is a place in the same plaza with us.
Yeah, it's the same plaza as us, and they make cakes, and I got them a cake, and it said congratulations on it. Ariel got, she was coming back from the coast that day, so Ariel went and got paper plates and forks and, little, like, poppers, and you'll see that in the video of their ceremony. And then also, like, we signed the witness forms and everything. It was so cool. MJ joined.
Colton's wife.
Yes, Colton's wife. And Ariel did come in when she wasn't supposed to work because she also wanted to be part of it.
So check out the clip right here.
Marriage is like a beautiful gift. And many people believe when they get that gift, it's a box that's filled with everything they've ever wanted. Happiness, romance, and the list goes on and on. But in reality, it's an empty box. And the couple must put something into the box, each of them, each day, before they can take anything out. Because if they take more out of the box than they put into the box, soon their marriage will be empty. So I'd like you to just imagine that after today, you're going to create a very magic garden. And just imagine a garden with a large wall around it and a door. And only the two of you have the key to the door. And when you open that door, that is the time that you reconnect with one another and that you foster that love that you have. And that often during the week, you take each other's hands and take a few minutes to return to that garden and just be there for each other. So now, let the power of your love and the strength of your dedication to each other make you inseparable. Be close, but not too close, because you each have your own journey of life to walk, but now you're agreeing to share that the storms are going to come, but they will pass quickly. Always remember that the sun shines behind those clouds, and always remember to go out and kiss and dance in the rain. And now for the words you've been waiting to hear. With our best wishes, by the laws of the state of Washington, it is my honor to pronounce you husband and wife. Please kiss and celebrate your love.
Oh,
I didn't even do it.
Oh, it's like.
Twist
oh.
it like this.
I think so. He hasn't broken the window yet, so.
So that is pretty cool. Yeah.
Yeah. It's really cool. I'm like trying not to like make a huge deal out of it, but I'm like,
I mean,
and then I cried during like taking the video.
how many game stores can say that they have had a wedding in their shop? Like, that is so cool, so unique, And I love that they thought of us. And
yes, it means so much.
Like, it almost sounded a little bit sad when they're like, we don't have any family or friends that live around here.
Yeah, because I think that they're from the coast.
Yeah.
So they do live closer now, but they really wanted people who they knew would like enjoy their ceremony. And they also said like they're not into like traditional stuff. So they weren't even expecting a cake. I was just like, it's your wedding.
Yeah.
You know, let's have a cake. Let's have like the little poppers. And we wanted to make it special.
And I was going to say like it kind of sounds a little sad when you say it like that, like they didn't have any friends or family and they wanted to do it
at
a game store.
They have friends or family.
They just don't have them that are local. But it is like, I'm saying I think it sounds sad, but it's mm-hmm. not sad. And for us especially, it's like what an honor, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's just so cool.
I like think about it and I just start crying. I and MJ took like photos and videos for them just because like we're like, you know, like you need to remember this. And so that's why the video is vertical and not like horizontal, because that's what those requested. And we took photos and I am so excited for them. They're such a wonderful couple and it doesn't change anything, but now they get to like continue to be a wonderful couple, and it makes me feel really like special, but also like I'm so happy for them.
So you guys saw the video, so now with their permission, of course, we're going to show you guys a few of the photos and a little bit of a montage here, and Jesse will probably put some sappy music over it. At the end of the day there,
yeah,
we had Monkey Ball 2, Billy Hatcher, and a Wave Bird traded in.
A disgusting Wave Bird. But a Wave Bird.
Well, right before we closed. But the vlog's not over yet, because we're doing something for my birthday. I'm not sure where we're going. I have an idea, but we'll see. But we'll do a little bit of filming. Not too much, because I just want to have fun and enjoy the time. But some people have already wished me happy birthday, so thank you to you guys. And
happy
thank
birthday.
You to anyone in the comments who's saying it right now. Let's go!
Let's go!
I'd never even been here before. Did you know that?
Yes, I did know
that. Whoa. Who told you?
Me.
Ryan. We're bowling. We're at round one. And guess who's here? What's that? Non-tubers? What? Go, Kyle. What's up? You think anyone watching remembers Cassidy?
No, man. Cassidy's favorite game is over there. What is it?
Monopoly! Monopoly! So we got non-tubers over there. I know some of you guys remember him. What a beginner! Look at that footwork. This is non-tubers! You guys remember him.
I'm sure some of you do. There are some out there that will recall. They probably look a little different, but yeah.
Look exactly the same. Thank you for coming.
Yeah.
I haven't seen him in such a long time.
It's a cool spot. Good place.
It is awesome in here. If you guys are in Vancouver, come to the Vancouver Mall and check out round one. It's a lot of fun. Look what I won. Well, Abby got this.
Oh, your hair.
But I won this from one of the claw machines. He's gonna go on the game room couch as one of the pillows. And Abby got this little guy.
Wait, Jess has a matching one.
Yes.
Yeah. Nice.
Hi.
That's it, guys. We are done now. It's 11:39 p.m. and we gotta get home so we can upload these clips for Jesse, go to bed, and wake up tomorrow to come back to the store to work. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for the birthday wishes, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.
Hey, wait.
What?
I gotta tell you something.